Hey, Ted, over here. An old army buddy of mine runs a business in Rockford. We saw action in Nicaragua back when the country knew what it was doing. Anyway, some cartel scum roughed him up yesterday. Said they'd be back for some of his stock today. He's gonna need backup, and in return, they'll give you a knockdown rates on any hardware you buy. I'd go myself, but the old sciatica's playing up. good luck.
Phoned ahead, but I thought there'd be more of you. Can't believe those yellow belly bastards left me without proper cover again. Well, three arms are better than one, so grab whatever you need. Those Colombians will be here any minute.
Hey, if I teamed up with you in Nicaragua, maybe I'd still have my arm. If you need any firepower, just drop by and take what you need from the lockers. Leave the cash under the bench. Now get out of here. I'll handle the cops.
I know a real important man in town, a soft touch with, shall we say, exotic tastes and the money to indulge them. He's involved in a legal matter, and the prosecution has some rather embarrassing photos of him at a morgue party or something. The evidence is being driven across town. You are going to have to ram that car and collect each little bit of evidence as it falls out. When you've got it all, leave it in the car and torch it. We're both going to do pretty well out of this, kid.
PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
Leave me alone!
Flashback FM, where every night's a dance party.
This is Tony on Flashback FM. Liberty City's home for the best in disco, electro, and new wave.
A TV event that will make history. Liberty City.
reality TV to a whole new level. We'll take 20 recently paroled guys, equip them with grenade launchers and flamethrowers, and let them hunt each other down. It's the reality show where you just might be part of the action.
I was grabbing a sandwich at the Happy Blimp, and all of a sudden these guys crashed through the window and started shooting at each other. I was so excited, I didn't even notice I'd been hit. After that, I was hooked on Liberty City Survival. I watch it every day in the hospital.
The game doesn't end until there's only one man left standing. Tune in nightly or watch the 24-hour live webcast. Natural selection has come home. Sponsored by Emmy Nation. Remember to put litter in its place. Thank you.
This one reminds me of waking up on the tour bus. What's his name? The one with the highlights and the mascara? He was wearing this gray jacket with shoulder pads, and he started playing along to this song on a kazoo. We were wild.
Maria and I have gone shopping. Our source in the police has informed us that one of our drivers is a strangely animated undercover cop. He's more or less useless out of his car, so we've tagged it with a tracer. Make him bleed.
First of all, let me thank you for dealing with that personal matter. People will read something into anything these days. Experience has taught me that a man like you can be very loyal for the right price, but groups of men get greedy. A valued resource, an old Oriental gentleman I know, has been kept hostage by some South Americans in Espatria. They're trying to extort additional funds from me, but I don't believe in renegotiation. A deal is a deal. so they'll not see a penny from me. Go and rescue my friend. Do whatever it takes.
She's on fire.
Nothing drives down real estate prices like a good old-fashioned gang war, apart from an outbreak of plague. But that might be going too far in this case. I've noticed the Yakuza and the Colombians are far from friends. Let's capitalize on this business opportunity. I want you to kill the Yakuza Wakagashira, Kenji Kassen. Kenji is attending a meeting at the top of the multi-story car park in Newport. Get a cartel gang car and eliminate him. The Yakuza must blame the cartel for this declaration of war.
Wasn't that just great? Next week, we've got our big bi-monthly phone-in when you get the chance to win a meal for two at a fast food outlet of your choice, as long as you choose one of our competition sponsors.
Finally, pop music's got a new voice.
Hello.
Welcome to Lips 106.
Hey, this is Andy on the Lips 106.
My girlfriend Cherise, and this maniac comes right up on my bumper, flashing his lights, and I'm like, hey guy, the light is red, you can't just come up behind me honking and flashing your lights. Then he gets over this megaphone and says, to the woman in the teal my bobsu monstrosity, please move to the side. Can you believe it? I mean, who has a megaphone rigged into their car? People are so obnoxious these days. And rude. I mean, I tell my name, my kids for manners.
You know, I think that's a lesson to us all. All right, hello, next caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Hello, Nightmare. That woman says she was a nanny because Freddy needs a nanny because he's been a very naughty boy.
No nannies. Let's go to our next caller, all right.
Colonel James T., United States Marine Corps, 2nd Battalion. Laszlo, that caller made a really valid point. These kids today have no respect for authority. And there is one thing that would whip them into shape.
Let me guess, the military.
That's right. The military teaches you respect, obedience, and it gives you a good pension. These kids that thought they were going to be millionaires, look where the super information highway has gotten them. Nowhere. It's a dead end. Uncle Sam takes care of his boys and some girls. If more people would join the military, this would be a better country. I tell you another thing about respect. These kids don't respect veterans. We fought for your freedom. When I came back from the Australian-American War, I didn't get a hero's welcome. I didn't get a pat on the back from my friends and neighbors saying, thanks for fighting for our freedom, James. After years of fighting in the trenches, I come back here and everyone's watching TV.
Now, can you tell me what this Australian-American War was? I mean, I really never heard of it.
God, not another one. Have you read a history book lately, son? The Australian-American War was the biggest war since the big one. I tell you, I didn't do two tours and take boomerang shrapnel in my head so I could come back here and have a bunch of hippies deny history. Those Aussies are ruthless. They even wired kangaroos with explosives. Come hopping into camp. Knock out 10 guys.
Well, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah? Is that Laszlo?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
My name ain't important. It's real unimportant, okay?
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. If you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant, I just got shot in the head, unimportant. Do I make myself clear?
Yes. Why are you calling in today?
Because I need some advice, and I ain't doing any of that shrink shit.
Tony.
Tony? How'd you know my name was Tony? You're tracing this call? Because if you are,